Hi, I'm Andy, and I'm back to show you the new features of version 4.1, CL and QL. Let's take a look. There's a bunch of new features regarding Dante. So let's go to Dante setup, and here, look, we can see we're now supporting AES67 mode. This allows us to connect to a bunch of non-Dante devices. And also we're supporting the new Dante device lock function. Let's move over to this computer with Dante controller. So if you double click on the device name, you go to the device view and we get this AES67 page where you can enable or disable the device. That one's enabled, this one is disabled. And also here we can see the device lock. Click there and then type a PIN code and confirm it. And then that device is going to be locked, meaning you cannot change its patch or its other settings. And it's neat because in the console, that is going to show you in the I/O device menu, you can see which devices are locked and which devices are in AES67 mode. Back to the computer and in the transmit tab, you know, you can enter channel labels. Well, these labels can also appear on the console to help you do your patching. Let's go back and we just go to selected channel, look at the patching, and look, these names here are the ones that you've entered in Dante controller. Very, very useful. Now, there's a few new devices that we are supporting. So let's go to device mount and take a look here. And we can see that we have a DMB device here, DS10. We can do discover that and do the patching. Then here we've got Dante MY16 AUD2, the MY card. The new version supports daisy chain connection and a few additional sample rates. So that's well worth looking into. And then a bunch of Shure devices, which are actually not Dante devices, but we can control them. AXT range of wireless receivers, and scrolling a bit further, QLXD range, and the additional ULXD that doesn't have Dante. So all these devices can be mounted and controlled from the console. Hey, I've made another video about that, so look for it. And to control them, we need a bit of network setting up. There's now two pages here. The first one is for the network port that we use for iPad, iPhone apps, and the computer editor software. This one is for device control, like the Shure devices that actually connect through the Dante port. We can do DHCP, auto IP, or static IP, so flexible setups. Now, it's about time we talked about an audio function. Let's go to the EQ. And we can see here, look, you can change the type. Well, you can change the type globally. If you want all inputs to be smooth, for example, then apply. Yeah, quick and easy. And another thing, we have an offset for the RTA. So you can see the level's a little bit low. You can boost it by increasing the offset. Makes it much clearer. If we go to the RTA page here, and we see the offset, then we have a new peak hold. That will hold the peaks while keeping the bars underneath bouncing up and down nicely. Now let's quickly move over to the QL console here. And on this channel EQ, you can see we've highlighted the band that's selected. So when you select a band here, you see the highlight change. Or when you select a band on the screen, you see the highlight change. Just makes it a little bit quicker and easier to use. So I hope you've enjoyed discovering all these version 4.1 features. Remember to check the other two videos we've got, one for AES67 and the other one for the additional Shure wireless mic control. Thanks for watching. Thank you.